and welcome to today's video. So today I'm going to be unboxing this Look Fantastic beauty box that I actually won very recently in a giveaway from the lovely Beauty by Zoe. So I will link her channel in the description, be sure to go and check that out. But I just thought it would be fun to get this unboxed, have a look at everything inside, maybe have a little look to see what the products are worth, because I know sometimes in these boxes the RRPs are astronomical. So yeah, thought it would be interesting, and if that's the kind of video you'd like to watch, then carry on watching. So first up, I do really have to say, with these Look Fantastic boxes, I do love that they come in a really hefty box. So I've got one just here that's got loads of makeup bits in. I've got one, you can maybe just see the orange just in the corner there, that's storing loads of my other palettes. So yeah, I do like that the boxes are definitely reusable. So let's get this opened up. So of course we have got the lovely Look Fantastic tissue paper here. Something in here smells really nice, I can tell you that for certain. So loads of really lovely looking goodies in here. There's just a little peek of some of the bits. So let's have a look at these in a bit more detail, and then yeah, have a little look and see how much that they're worth. So the first thing I pulled out is this Beauty Pro Brightening Sheet Mask. And this has got collagen, vitamin C and aloe vera. So it says here that this is to brighten complexion and also improves elasticity, targets fine lines and wrinkles. Yeah, it just seems like pretty straightforward face mask. It's made in Korea. It's cruelty free, which is excellent. And yeah, just an anti-aging collagen sheet mask with vitamin C. I do actually use the vitamin C like serum after I've done all my other skincare bits and bobs, so this should complement that really nicely. I have had a little look online, and apparently the sheet mask should cost £4.95 on its own, which I'm a big lover of a sheet mask. Like, I do have quite a lot of them. I do like to use them on a regular basis along with the clay masks, but I don't think I would pay £4.95 just for one mask. So this is going to have to do a really, really amazing job and like anti-age me by like 10 years for me to probably consider spending that much on a face mask. But nonetheless, it is always great to try out new products and new brands and be able to perhaps use products that are a bit more expensive and that you wouldn't normally go out and spend money on. But yeah, looks pretty good. I will see what's next. So the next product is this Christophe Robin Hydrating Melting Mask. And this has got aloe vera for hydrated hair, shiny and plumped length. And this is for dehydrated and dull hair. And I'd say my hair is pretty dull. It's not really like anything special. I do actually have a Christophe Robin hair mask. I think it's the prickly pear one, and I think I got that in like another Look Fantastic box, and I remember that being pretty pricey. But having said that, it is a really, really good hair mask, so I have really high hopes for this one. It has got a really quite subtle fragrance, but it is a really, really nice. It definitely smells natural rather than smelling overly chemically, which I like in a hair mask. It does recommend using the hydrating shampoo, which obviously I don't have. Apply a small amount onto wet hair, beginning with the scalp, massaging from root to tip, leaving for 2 minutes before rinsing thoroughly. And it says follow with the hydrating mist to boost shine, which of course I don't have as well. But I'm really hoping this is going to do well, because I could do with, you know, shiny hair or a bit more plumping, because my hair is quite flat. It smells nice, so I'm going to probably enjoy popping this on my hair anyway. And I've had a little look online, and the full size of this is 200 mils, and that's £28. So we can probably guess this is about £5 worth of hair mask, but 40 mils is quite a lot, and you don't really need an awful lot of this on your hair. So I reckon I could get a good few uses out of this, and then I'll be able to really obviously establish whether I think it's good value or not. Okay, this is the next thing I have pulled out, and this is a By Terry Balm de Rose Nourishing Lip Balm. So nice packaging here, nice shiny lid. It's got what it is on the bottom, which is always helpful, and quite an interesting applicator here now that it's sort of bent off at an angle. Definitely a mild rose fragrance coming from it. I've actually got a rose cleanser that I use from Primark, and it actually just smells like that. Just popped a little swatch on my hand that you probably can't even see, but it has got a really quite a light pink shade to it. It is definitely, when you rub it in, feels like a balm rather than feeling like a gloss, which is what I initially thought this was. So yeah, it definitely smells nice. It's gone into my hand quite nicely, so high hopes that it will go into my lips nicely. Obviously not going to apply it now because I have got lipstick on. According to their website, this has a natural glossy finish and is for fuller and plumper lips. This is pretty pricey, so just this small size of this by Terry lip balm is retailing for £14, which for a lip balm is pretty pricey. I've never tried anything from by Terry before, so I can't speak for the brand or, you know, the quality of their products or whether they do what they say they're going to do. So yeah, interested to try this one out and yeah, see if it does what it says it's going to do. Next up, I've actually got another makeup product, and I've seen the name of this brand before, but I've never known how to pronounce it. So I have just Googled it, and it is Mina. And this is their Colour Pen Eyeliner. And this is a brown liquid liner, which I'm really interested in because I really like a felt tip liner like this one. And I've got felt tip liner just in black and white, but I haven't got a brown. So this looks really, really good and really perfect shade, especially for like autumn, winter that we're in now. Come out at quite a really nice dark brown, and the tip itself feels like the perfect amount of moistness. It's dried on my hand actually really, really quickly as well. So that gives me high hopes for doing my actual eyeliner with this. And again, I've never tried anything by this brand, but I have heard of them. I've had a little look to see how much this eyeliner retails for, and it's about £5 for this size of eyeliner pen. And as I said, for me, this is perfect because I much prefer a felt tip liner than I do like a proper liquid liner. I find that for me, it's just, I get a better precision with the pen, and they always tend to dry down a bit quicker as well, and just make that fiddly job of doing your eyeliner a little bit easier. So yes, very interested to see how I get on with this one. This is the second to last item in this Look Fantastic box, and again, another brand that I've not heard of. So this is the next product. This is by SVR, and this is their Palpebral cream. It's for irritated eyelids and is an anti-itching soothing cream. So let me find the side of this that's in English, because most of it's actually in French. This is for hypersensitive to irritated eye contours. Offers 24-hour hydration. It immediately soothes and relieves itching, curbs the appearance of irritation, smooth cream texture and long lasting comfort. So they recommend that you apply this once to twice a day. It's got hyaluronic acid in and omega 3, 6 and 9, which means absolutely nothing to me, but sounds very fancy. So I do tend to find that sometimes I do get quite itchy eyes, and I'm one of those people that will just rub them and rub them and rub them, which probably does absolutely no good whatsoever. So this looks like this will be pretty good. Comes in this little tube here, very small application, which is quite good. Has a very, very mild fragrance, but again, it's not chemically, which is absolutely perfect, because I really hate when products that you're going to put, especially on your face and even more so near your eyes, when they're really chemically, because I always just get worried they're going to sting, or even the fragrance itself is just going to be a bit stingy. So this looks pretty good. always up for trying out something new and giving a new brand and a new product a go. So I feel no different about this one. Had a little look online. This retails for £15, which probably is the going rate for an eye cream or this kind of thing. So I think that that's probably pretty good value, unless it does absolutely nothing, and in which case then obviously it's not good value. And then this is the last product in this Look Fantastic box, and this is the Ameliorate Smoothing Body Exfoliant with Alpha Hydroxy Therapy. And this is specialist skincare for bumpy skin, very dry skin, rough skin, and ingrown hairs. It's an intensive hydrating retexturizer, and this is the 50ml tube. So, directions here. Use 2 to 3 times weekly, massage into dry skin before showering or bathing, leave on the skin for a few minutes, and then rinse off. This looks pretty good. I do find, especially in the winter, my skin just gets a bit drier. I'm guessing it's where it's like a bit colder and just not so nice. It's got a very, very mild fragrance again, so thumbs up for that one, and does look like a pretty good size tube. I'm guessing if you're doing your legs though, you're probably not going to get like tons and tons of uses out of this. I'm interested to see how I get on with this. Initially I thought it was just like a hand cream, which again I'm always in need of because my hands are the driest, especially in winter. I go through hand cream like there's no tomorrow, but yeah, I think I will give this a go for my legs, and I guess I'll have to report back and let you know how I get on with it. I've had a little look online to see how much this item RRP is for, and it is actually £10 for this tube, which again, I think is pretty good value. It's not the most expensive kind of cream I've seen, not the cheapest. If it does the trick though, I think £10 is a bargain. So that was everything that was in my Look Fantastic box. I hope that you enjoyed seeing everything that was in there. Let me know if you have tried out any of these products, or if you have a favourite, I'd really love to know. I have unboxed a few Look Fantastic boxes before, mainly the mystery boxes, so if you're interested in checking out those, then definitely do so. But thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy the video, please do give it a big thumbs up, leave me a comment, and if you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you again in my next video.